Hi my dear friends, welcome back to our YouTube channel. This is your ADC, ADC Max. I hope everyone is fine. So you are doing good in your end. Please kindly be safe, be happy and be healthy. That is very important. Okay, yeah, please take care of your health. This is another interesting matrix. Okay, how to get the eigenvalues and the vectors of the given matrix. So first of all, let's see the matrix. 2 minus 2, 2, 1, 1, 1, 1, 3 minus 1. So it is very clear that it is the non-symmetric matrix. So non-symmetric matrix, there are two cases are there. Already we have discussed the separate video. Please kindly go and watch. Distinct eigenvalues and repeated eigenvalues. So this is the one of the type with the repeated eigenvalue, but something is interesting. Okay. It is not the usual technique to get the eigenvectors under the repeated eigenvalues. So see this question. Yeah, this is a 3 by 3 matrix. So the eigenvalues of A are, we get from these determinant A minus lambda equal to 0. The short form or the third degree polynomial for the 3 by 3 matrix is lambda cube minus S1 lambda squared plus S2 lambda minus S3 equal to 0. And S1 represents the sum of the leading diagonal elements, 2 plus 1 plus minus 1, it is 2. And S2 represents sum of the diagonals minors through the diagonals. So first minor, close this row and this column, 1, 1, 3, minus 1. And second minor is 1, close this column and this row, 2, 2, 1, minus 1. And third diagonal is minus 1, close this row and column, get 2, minus 1, 1, 1. So 1, 3 is 1 into minus 1, minus 1, minus 3, and minus 2, minus 2, 2 plus 2. So 4, this is minus 4, this is minus 4. At cancellation of this one, we get minus 1. What about S3? S3 is the determinant of the matrix, so plus, minus, plus. So plus 2 into this row and this column. So 1, 1, 3, minus 1. Minus of minus 2. So this row and this column, 1, 1, 1, minus 1. And third one is plus 2 into this column is eliminated, this row is eliminated. So 1, 1, 1, 3. So let us see that 2 into 1 into minus 1 is minus 1, minus of minus 3. Minus of minus plus 2, 1 into minus 1 is minus 1, minus 1 into 1. And plus 2 into 1, 3 is 3, 1, 1 is 1. So minus 4 into 2 and minus 2 into 2 and plus 2 into 2. I think so this will cancel. So minus 8 is the answer. Let us substitute S1, S2 and S3 to get the polynomial lambda cube minus 2 lambda squared minus 4 lambda, because S2 is minus 4, minus 4 lambda minus S3 minus or minus plus 8 equal to 0. So using long division method to determine the eigenvalues to get the first eigenvalue, let us collect the coefficients of the highest polynomial term to the constant term. So this is 1, a minus 2, minus 4, and plus 8, because minus or minus plus 8, yeah, 8 is the even number. As I told you that this is also known as the trial and error method. So I go with the 8 means plus 2 or minus 2. So I start the plus 2 here, starting from 0, 1 plus 2, 1 plus 0 is 1, vertically, 1, 2 are 2, minus 2 plus 2 is 0, 0 to 2 is 0, minus 4 plus 0 is minus 4, minus 4 to 0 is minus 8, 8 minus 8, 0. So lambda equal to 2 is the one among the eigenvalue. What about the others two? Let us reduce the equation B. This is the coefficient of lambda squared. This is the coefficient of lambda. This is a constant term. So lambda squared minus 4 equal to 0. Other is lambda equal to plus or minus 2. So plus 2, here also 1 plus 2. So this plus 2 is repeated twice the time and minus 2 repeated only one time. Right, sir? So among the three eigenvalues, 2 are repeated twice. Right. Now find the eigenvectors of A. The eigenvectors of A are given by A minus lambda I into x equal to 0. It's a matrix equation. It's a matrix. X is the non-zero column matrix. So subtract lambda from the diagonal. 2 minus lambda, 1 minus lambda, minus 1 minus lambda. So multiply this row into column wise. We get the first equation and the second one, middle one with the same. We get the second equation and third one, third row with this column. We get the third equation. So this is my star equation. Now my aim is to substitute the various lambda values in the star equation. We will get the corresponding eigenvectors, right? Right, sir? So when I substitute lambda is equal to minus 2 in this star equation, it's the case number 1. By putting lambda equal to minus 2 in the star equation, see that 2 minus of minus 2 plus 4 x1 minus 2 x2 plus x3 equal to 0. And x1, 1 minus of minus plus 2, so 3x2 plus x3 equal to 0. And the third equation is same. So these two are similar equations. Using the cross multiplication rule, I need at least two distinct equations. Now these two are similar, right sir? These two are similar. So can I pick the first 1 and 2? So start with the middle variable. The coefficients are minus 2, 3, 2, 1, 4, 1, minus 2, 3. So this is will give x1. Minus 2 into 1 is minus 2. Minus of 3, 2 are 6. And x2 gives 2 into 1 is 2. 1 minus 4, minus 4. And x3 is 4, 3 are 12. Minus of minus plus 2. So this minus 8, minus 2, 14. Multiply by minus 2, we get 4, 1, minus 17. So this is the first eigenvector corresponding to lambda equal to minus 2. Lambda is equal to minus 2. What about the second case? So the case number 2, substitute the lambda is equal to plus 2 in the star equation. If I substitute lambda equal to plus 2 in the star equation, see that 2 minus 2, 0. So 0x1 minus 2x2 plus 2x3 is equal to 0. And here x1, 1 minus 2 is minus x2 plus x3 equal to 0. The third one, x1 plus 3x2, by putting lambda equal to 2, we get it is minus 3x3 is equal to 0. Can you see that? This is the beauty of this problem, because these three equations are distinct. These equations are different. Once we have distinct equation, you can use the cross multiplication, you get the eigenvector. But how many eigenvectors? Only one. That is the unique eigenvector. Unique eigenvector. So you will get only one eigenvector corresponding to lambda equal to plus 2. Only one eigenvector, because of the system of equations are distinct. So can we use the cross multiplication rule? We get the unique eigenvector which is corresponding to lambda is equal to plus 2. So can we use 1 and 2? Yeah, we go for this as minus 2, minus 1, 2, 1 and 0, 1, minus 2, minus 1. So this will use the x1, this is the x2, this is the x3. So 2 into minus 1. Let us see that. 2 into minus 1. So let us get the x3. This is x1 by minus 2 into 1 is minus 2. Minus of minus is plus 2. Is equal to x2 by 2 ones are 2. 1 into 0 0. So 2 minus 0. And x3 by 0 into minus 1 is 0. Minus 1 into minus of minus 2 is plus 2. So which gives x1 by 0, x2 by 2 and x3 by 2. So multiply this by 2, you will get, the x1 by 0, x2 by 1, x3 by 1. So what about the capital X3? So capital X3, the third eigenvector is equal to the second eigenvector is equal to 0, 1, 1. So this is the unique eigenvector. This is the unique eigenvector corresponding to the lambda is equal to plus 2. Why this is unique? Why? Because the system of equations are distinct. Once we have distinct equation, which gives the single eigenvector, this is called the unique eigenvector. Once we have same equation, which may generate different eigenvectors by assuming that x1 0, x2 0, x3 0. Separate video I made for non-symmetric with repeated eigenvalue with the equations are same. Please go and watch. So this problem is non-symmetric matrix with repeated eigenvalues, with repeated eigenvalues, what about the eigenvector? We get the unique eigenvector. So this is the beauty of this problem. Please kindly go and watch the other videos like non-symmetric matrix with distinct eigenvalues, non-symmetric value vectors, that is non-symmetric matrix with equal or repeated eigenvectors. But this is the third one, non-symmetric matrix with unique eigenvector. Thank you. Thank you so much for watching our YouTube channel. Please kindly subscribe and share, comment our YouTube channel, so that with help of your comments and your suggestion, your recommendations and your constant support only, I made some interesting, innovative, informative videos for you. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you.